5.5 number 43, we are going to integrate, and this integral right here is like the same as 1 over square root of 1 minus x squared times inverse sine x, and they just put the dx on the top. Usually it's on the side, but it doesn't matter. Well, we have two choices for u, it seems like it, and if you let u is equal to square root of 1 minus x squared, or if you let u is equal to the inside 1 minus x squared, it's not going to do any good, because the derivative of them is not going to be able to cancel out with the inverse sine. However, if I make u equals to the inverse sine x, and differentiating this, I will get du, derivative of this is 1 over square root of 1 minus x squared dx. To solve for dx, I have to just multiply both sides by the square root of 1 minus x squared. So dx is square root of 1 minus x squared du. And as you can see that now we see this right here, it's going to be able to cancel with that. So now I'm going to take this integral to the u world. It's going to be on the top. Well, since they put the dx on the top, let me just put the du on the top, dx on the top as well. We will have this to replace for the dx. So I will have square root of 1 minus x squared du on the numerator, and that will be over the denominator is that square root of 1 minus x squared multiplying by inverse sine x, which is the same as u, so it multiplied by u, and as we can see, this and that cancels, and we are good because this integral is just integral of, let me write this as 1 over u, right? And then let me put the du on the side. To integrate 1 over u, the answer for that is ln. You attach the absolute value of u, and that's pretty much it. And finally, we'll just write u back. U is equal to inverse sine x. So the final answer will be ln with an absolute value, inverse sine x. And we have the plus c at the end. And especially we have to keep the absolute value here because sometimes the inverse sine x can be negative numbers, right? So I'll just leave it like this. Done for the answer.